working all by himself.
Alright, so well, sometimes to understand where we are, we have to go back and assess where we've been. And so I go back in time and I look at the beginning of 2011. I look at the awakening that took place, and it was such an awakening that there was a feeling of no turning back. Such a change and a spiritual awakening, so that my eyes were able to see and ears receive a message that brought the Bible to life. It brought God's Word to life. And many of you have experienced this. So, you know, I have to sometimes take myself back to that point and wonder, and I don't really wonder, but I take myself back to that point and say, okay, now let me ask you this question. If you were awakened in such a way that you started to see a number appear all the time, and you prayed about it, you were the reason you were seeing this is because you were starting to study God's Word more and more in your life, and you were seeking Him more than ever before in your life, not by chance, because He drew you in. He drew you into this point, and you started to see this number all the time, and you kept praying and wondering why. And if it's not of the Lord, I rebuke it by the power of the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, that it go away. And if it's of you, Lord, increase it. And you're taken straight to the Scripture, not searching in the Bible, thinking, what could this be? He takes you straight to, behold, I'm coming soon. So He tells you He's coming soon. And you continue to see the number. And just to make sure that you got the message, He confirms it when you go to bed on March 10th and have a dream of being in the earthquake in Japan, and wake up saying, I had a dream I was in an earthquake in Japan, and bam, there's the news, earthquake in Japan and tsunami. He confirms it with that and says, were you paying attention? Are you really awake? Are you awake now? Do you understand what I'm trying to get across to you? Is that I am coming soon, and what happened in Japan is what's going to happen all over the world. That's just a small... This is the beginning of sorrows, Todd. This is just a small example of what is going to take place in the tribulation. What you saw in Japan is a microcosm, a small little fragment of what's going to take place worldwide when the earthquakes go off and the volcanoes erupt and the New World Order gets put in place and the Antichrist rises to power. It's going to be the most turbulent time in the world's history. It will make the Nazi concentration camps look like child's play, and Hitler will be, he was just practice run for what's going to take place. Do you understand? And now, will you go tell everyone that I'm coming? And tell everyone to please choose me, and to come into me, and to be saved by my blood, that sins may be forgiven, and that people may walk in a deeper relationship of intimacy, to become my bride that was chosen and picked out. Those that want to enter by the narrow gate. Those who want to seek a deeper relationship. Those who want me above the world. They don't want one foot in the world and one foot in my kingdom. They want to be completely in my kingdom. They want to be set apart, a people, a peculiar people, set apart from the world. This is what I want you to spread the message about. This is what I want you to do. This is what you are being called to do. Will you be obedient? Or will you follow man? Will you be shaken by man and told to stop because this is lunacy. This is foolishness. Well, the foolishness of God's wiser than man's wisdom. God told us that. When he wants to tell his message of his soon return, it'll be met with scoffing. He's told us that. It'll be met with mocking. He's told us that. It'll be met with ridicule. It'll be met with people saying, even in your own household or your own family, that you don't know what you're talking about. Will you stay faithful to me? Will you continue to deliver the word? Will you continue to tell people that they don't have forever, that at some point I will come back? Tell them I am coming soon. Tell them. And that's the only reason that I'm here on this YouTube channel. The only reason that I would come out and say anything is specifically for those to come into the kingdom. It's specifically to sound the alarm of Jesus Christ's soon return. And I've told you, I don't know the day or the hour. I don't know when it is, but I know that on March 11th, 2011, this is what he did in my life. That was that. That's what he did. So today's the day. Today's the day to make a decision for Christ. Today's the day to stop being lukewarm. Today's the day to be hot. Today's the day to be filled with the Holy Spirit. Today is the day of salvation. Today is the day that he may come to take us. Tomorrow may be the day. You only have this day that you live in. Let tomorrow take care of itself. But today is the day to make a decision for Christ. Today's the day to cry out to him and say, Lord Jesus, I don't want to be left here. I don't want to have to face all of the destruction that's coming, the judgment that shall come upon the earth. I don't want to be here for that. I love you, Lord Jesus, and I'm sorry I've lived my life more in the world instead of putting you as the priority. I'm sorry that I put everything above you, which is what you would call idols. Anything that you put above God, it doesn't matter what it is, if it's a child, if it's a spouse, if it's a football team, if it's material possessions, if it's whatever, and we could make a long list, but anything that's so important to you that you put more time and invest more time in that than you do trying to find your relationship with Christ or spending intimate time in the Word or, you know, devoting yourself to His kingdom purpose in your life, your assignment, whatever you're here for, is to bring glory to Him. That's why He made you, for His purposes, not your own, not for this world. We're not supposed to be here to just please ourselves 24/7 and forget that we have a Creator and a Savior that died on the cross for us, that He shed His blood, that our sins may be forgiven. That's not why He did it. He did it to free you from the world, to help you overcome the world, to help me overcome the world, for us to be set apart, a city on a hill that can't be hidden, shine forth the light. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. That's what we're here for. We are here for His glory. And at some point, He's coming to take us home if we're found worthy. And we can't be worthy without His blood covering us. We can't be found worthy if we don't put Him first. We can't be found worthy if we're not a bride that's anticipating His return and we're being a faithful servant. If we're an unfaithful servant or a foolish virgin, that's not who He's coming for. Go read those parables. Go read Matthew 24, 25. Get into the Word. Let Him know you love Him. Time is short. We have to go back to the start sometimes. We have to reassess why we're really doing what we're doing. We have to understand that God loved us so much He gave His only Son, that through Him that we could be forgiven for all of our sins, to save us, to help us to overcome, to give us the strength, to make us different. What makes you tick? What makes you live each day? What are you driven by? Are you driven by your career? Are you driven by wanting to achieve more money and getting a bigger paycheck? Are you driven by wanting to get the next latest greatest iPad, iPhone, I this, I that, me? What are you driven by? I'm only telling you from my experiences. I've been there, and I don't want to go back to that. It's too late to go back to that. The time is so short. We don't know how much time we have. This may be the day. I pray that this is the day that you choose Christ. I pray that this is the day that He becomes the priority. And if you follow Him, then everything else will line up. If you follow Him and you put Him first, then all these other things will be added unto you. I pray that today is the day of salvation for you. Today is the day for a greater commitment to the kingdom. That when you go there, that there'll be There'll be rewards that won't be burned by fire, that they won't burn up by wood, stubble, and hay. There's more to what we're trying to achieve in this life than the wealth and the riches of this world. It's about what awaits us in the glory of heaven, that we live in an eternity with our Father, because our Savior Jesus paid the ultimate price to buy us a ticket in. And we've got to focus on Him and accept that ticket. We've got to take it as a gift and say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you so much for forgiving me. I cleanse myself through your blood. I ask you to show me anything I need to correct in my life, that I can be in a walk with you, that we can be in a true relationship, that we can know each other, so you don't tell me on that day, depart from me, I never knew you. That's not the words you want to hear. That's not the words I want to hear. So in this day, beloved, let's make a choice. Let's make a choice for love. Let's make a choice, because he gave it all. He gave everything he had. He gave it. He gave every ounce of his blood. He gave every ounce of his being. He took the beating. He took the pain for you and for me. So let's accept that gift, and let's turn away from the world and be separate and called out. Let's seek to walk in obedience with him. Let's seek to keep his commandments, Lord Jesus' commandments that he told us to love him above all other things, to put our God first, that we do that first, and we love our neighbors as ourselves, and we follow behind him. We pick up our cross. I love you all, and today in this day, Jesus is on his way. He's been delayed for a long time. And if that servant says, my Savior has delayed his coming, let's go out and party. Let's go out and live in the world. Let's go out and put everything above him, because I'll have time. I can sneak in there at the very last. I can make it into the party. When that door shuts, there won't be any time left. There'll be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Today's the age of grace. Today is the time that's been dedicated as the church age. Today's the time. Today is the day of grace. This sliver of grace that's left, however long, is the time to come to Jesus and recognize his sacrifice and love him for it. I love you all. Please accept him. Love him with your whole being. Don't be lukewarm. Be hot. Today's the day. We don't know what tomorrow brings. I love you all. God bless. Mama,